Good morning, students. In the previous class, we learned and know about electric charge and electric current. Now we continue with the next topic, and first we find or know about the conventional direction of electric current. Direction of electric current or conventional direction of current. In the nature of current, we learn the charges in a conductor or electrons in a conductor is moving in a particular direction, which constitute current in the circuit. We understood about the flow of current in the circuit is just opposite to the direction of current. This is flow of electron, flow of electrons. Therefore, we find the current is flowing in opposite direction of flow of current. That is, we write the direction of current as the conventional direction of current of current is opposite to the flow of electron, flow of electrons in the conductor. That is, it can be determined by the diagram as a bulb is connected in a circuit with the help of a cell positive terminal of cell is this, and this is the negative terminal. Therefore, we observe the current is flowing from the positive terminal to the circuit as shown in figure. So we also know that current is flows of electron in a conductor that is the direction of current in a conductor is opposite direction of flow of electron in the conductor. This is the direction of current, and this is understood by this diagram. Flow of electron. This is a piece of conductor in which electrons are moving from right to left, and upper side of this piece of conductor is written. This is the direction of flow of electron, and this is the direction of flow of current in the conductor. And by the demonstrating diagram, we also understood this is a battery or a source of current. From the positive terminal of the source of current, the current will induce or produce towards the negative terminal. Here, this is an important point. Direction of current is in a conductor is opposite direction of the flow of current. Some notes we write about the current. Just first copy this. Student, we know or we learn about the current is flows by the current, yeah, current is carried by the electron in the conductor. So the charge on electron is negative, and its value is given by -1.6 into 10 to the power -19 coulomb. Student, here coulomb is the unit of charge. COULUMB. This is the unit of charge. This is your first note. Second. In 1 second, from any cross section, from a cross section, of a conductor, electrons passing electron will pass. We take an explanation about the number of electron passing in 1 second. Explanation. Suppose, student, we have 1 coulomb of charge is passed through any conductor in 1 second. We have time is 1 second, and we know charge on electron. We write here -1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. Therefore, we have a formula which we learned in the previous class. Current charge on electron charge is given by N into E. Therefore, we calculate the number of electrons by using formula N is equal to Q upon E. When we putting the value 1 coulomb upon 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb, therefore we getting the result, this N is equal to 6.25 × 10⁻¹⁹ electrons. Hence, in 1 second, 6.25 × 10⁻¹⁹ electron will pass through a conductor in 1 coulomb of charge in 1 second. We take some units, smaller units of electric current. First one is milliampere. Ampere. The value of 1 milliampere is equal to 10⁻³ ampere. Second unit is microampere. Micro ampere. 1 micron ampere is equal to 10⁻⁶ एम्पियर. दीज आर सम स्मॉलर यूनिट फॉर इलेक्ट्रिक करंट.
स्टूडेंट कॉपी दिस.
ओके स्टूडेंट, नाउ वी टेक द न्यू टॉपिक इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल एंड पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस. फॉर नोइंग अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल एंड पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, फर्स्ट वी टेक एन एनालॉजी और लेट मी ट्राई टू अंडरस्टूड विच क्वांटिटी इज लीड्स टू द मूवमेंट ऑफ करेंट इन द कंडक्टर एंड विच इज़ द रिक्वायर्ड क्वांटिटी विच मेक्स द करेंट फ्लोज थ्रू द कंडक्टर. ओके स्टूडेंट, वी नो दैट a body is moves from higher level to level two the lower level. This fundamental basic rule of the nature, anything is travels or moves from high level to the low level. That is, अगर हम किसी भी चीज को ऊपर से नीचे से सोचते हैं कि ऊपर चला जाए और हम बिना किसी एनर्जी लगाए हम नीचे की चीज को ऊपर कर दें, ऐसा पॉसिबल नहीं है. बट अगर हम किसी ऊपर से चीज को यहां पर है और हम इसको फ्री छोड़ देते हैं, देन वी फाइंड कि द बॉडी विल मूव्स टुवर्ड्स द अर्थ बिकॉज ऑफ विच इज फ्रॉम द अबव फ्रॉम द अर्थ सरफेस द ग्रेविटी और ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इज ट्राई टू पुल इट डाउन. दिस इज द फंडामेंटल बेसिक रूल और अ थंब रूल विच मेक्स अ बॉडी और एनी थिंग इज ट्राई टू मूव डाउन. सो ये बात आप याद रखेंगे स्टूडेंट, कोई भी चीज हायर लेवल से लोअर लेवल की तरफ फ्लो करती है. ठीक है, दूसरा एनी थिंग इन द वर्ल्ड is try to stay at the minimum energy level. जितना कोई भी चीज नीचे होगी, कोई भी ऑब्जेक्ट जितना नीचे होगा उसके पास उतनी ही कम एनर्जी होगी और जिसके पास जितनी कम एनर्जी होगी उतना ही उसमें टेंशन होगा. सो अगर कोई चीज नीचे के लेवल पे है तो उसको फ्री वो रह सकता है बिना किसी अनदर टेंशन को एक्सपीरियंस किए हुए, तनाव को एक्सपीरियंस किए हुए. सो वी टेक एन एग्जाम्पल विच यू लर्न इन योर प्रीवियस क्लासेस. सपोज स्टूडेंट वी हैव टू कंटेनर ऑफ वाटर फिल्ड विथ टॉप एंड बोथ द कंटेनर्स आर कनेक्टेड with the help of a pipe and both are placed at the same level and in both the container water is filled to the top. We observe there is no flow of water from bucket A to bucket B. Because you all learn, if there is equilibrium in both the containers, then there is no flow of energy from one object to another. But if वाटर टैंक ए इज प्लेस्ड एट अ हायर लेवल देन वाटर टैंक बी एंड देन आफ्टर दे कनेक्ट विद ईच अदर देन वी ऑब्जर्व द फ्लो ऑफ वाटर फ्रॉम टैंक ए इज स्टार्ट टुवर्ड्स टैंक बी बिकॉज दिस इज टैंक ए इज एट हाई लेवल वेर इज टैंक बी इज एट लो लेवल. सो स्टूडेंट वी अंडरस्टूड अबाउट द वाटर इज ओनली एंड ओनली कैन फ्लो इफ देयर इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू टैंक ऑफ हाइट विच मीन्स अगर हाइट में डिफरेंस होगा वी हैव अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू वाटर टैंक बाय दिस हाइट. Because of this height, tank B has low energy, while tank A has high energy. Because of higher energy of tank A, water can able to flow to tank B. This is one example to understood the potential difference. Second, we take another example. You learn in your previous class about heat. Suppose student we have two objects, object A with 30 degree temperature and object B is connected with tank A or object A having 30 degree of temperature. Hence we find there is no flow of heat energy from any of the other. Okay, that is why, because tank A or object A and object B at the same temperature, because of this same temperature they have made their temperature equilibrium. And students, you learn if there is equilibrium or thermal equilibrium is between the two or more object, there is no flow of heat from any object. But if we change this condition by object A at 30 degree centigrade and object B is connected with it with having a temperature of 50 degree centigrade, so we observe here the heat is flows from object B to A till when they both get 40 degree centigrade temperature, which means when object A and B having their temperature 40 degree centigrade, the flow of transfer of heat is strong. Okay, because they get their thermal equilibrium or equilibrium of temperature between the two objects. So we find if any kind of equilibrium between the two or more objects having, so there is no transfer of energy takes place from any of the other object. But if any kind of difference is formed, like in water level, हम कम ज़्यादा करते हैं तो ज़्यादा और high level से low level की तरफ water flow करता है. Similarly, हमने पहले 30 degree centigrade पे दोनों objects को contact में रखा तो temperature का flow नहीं होता है. But when we kept near to each other with the difference of temperatures, object A is at 30 degree centigrade and object B is at 50 degree centigrade, we observe there is a flow of heat energy takes from B to A. This is the direction of heat flows, B to A. So this heat flows till the temperature between the two is become 40, because the sum of the 50 and 30 is 80, and the temperature is divided into two body. So the average temperature is 40 degree centigrade. So when they get 40 degree centigrade both, they get the thermal equilibrium or temperature equilibrium. In this case, the flow is stopped. Similarly, in the potential also. Now we understood about the electric potential or potential difference. Okay, student. Now we learn something about the electric potential. If two charged conductors are kept in contact by a metallic wire, the direction of current can be determined by a quantity called electric potential of the conductor. Therefore, potential is that electrical quantity quantity or state of a conductor which determines the direction of flow of charge is the direction of flow of charge when two conductor are kept in contact by a metallic wire. Copy this. Now we understood about the conductor having excess of electron is said to be at a negative potential or negative terminal or lower potential with higher concentration of electron, which means student, lower potential is said to be at higher concentration of electron, whereas the conductor with loss of electron, ऐसा conductor जिसमें से electron निकलते हैं, remove होते हैं, is said to be at a positive potential or higher potential with the lower concentration of electron. Suppose हमारे पास दो bodies हैं, object A and object B. मान लिया ऑब्जेक्ट ए के पास 10 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हैं और ऑब्जेक्ट बी के पास भी 10 इलेक्ट्रॉन हैं. हमने क्या किया कि ऑब्जेक्ट ए से दो इलेक्ट्रॉन को रिमूव कर दिया, तो हमारे पास ऑब्जेक्ट बी के पास कितने इलेक्ट्रॉन बच जाएंगे स्टूडेंट? तो आंसर है कि ऑब्जेक्ट बी इज लेफ्ट विद 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ओनली एंड वी एड 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन ऑब्जेक्ट ए. सो वी फाइंड द ऑब्जेक्ट ए लेफ्ट विद 12 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. तो हम बोलेंगे स्टूडेंट द ऑब्जेक्ट ए इज लो पोटेंशियल व्हाइल ऑब्जेक्ट बी इज एट हायर पोटेंशियल. हायर पोटेंशियल कैसे स्टूडेंट? तो सिंपल सी चीज है, आप सभी को पता है. आप मुझे बताइए कि या आप खुद सोचिए, अगर आपके पास दो नंबर्स हैं -10 और -4, विच नंबर इज ग्रेटर, -10 और -4? तो आंसर है कि -4 बड़ा है. क्यों -4 बड़ा है? बिकॉज -4 इज नियर टू द जीरो. That is why हम इस -4 को हम ऐसा कह सकते हैं, लाइक आपके पास एक नंबर था -10 एंड वन नंबर इज -4. When we subtract -10 from -4, we get the result is -4 minus -10. The result is we get +6. So answer is कि जो ऑब्जेक्ट -4 पोटेंशियल के साथ होगा उसके पास पॉजिटिव पोटेंशियल कंपेरिजन टू द पोटेंशियल ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट -10 इज +6. तो इसीलिए हम कहते हैं जिसके पास नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन कम है वो पॉजिटिव पोटेंशियल होगा और जिसके पास नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन ज्यादा है वो नेगेटिव पोटेंशियल होगा. कॉपी दिस विद एग्जाम्पल. ओके स्टूडेंट, इन कीपिंग विद द कन्वीनियंस ऑफ फ्लो फ्रॉम अ हाई लेवल टू अ लो लेवल विच वी डिस्कस्ड इन दिस टॉपिक अर्लियर, द वाटर कैन फ्लो फ्रॉम हायर लेवल टू लोअर लेवल. वी टेक द सेम कन्वीनियंस ऑफ फ्लो हाई लेवल टू द लो लेवल. द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज सेट टू बी flow from a region of higher potential to a region of lower potential, that is in direction opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. This be understood by a diagram. Here body A at negative potential and this is a body of positive potential. Here we understood body A at lower potential. अगर कोई body lower potential पे है तो इसका मतलब है कि उसके पास electron के numbers ज्यादा हैं, which means that body with high concentration of electron. Here the body B with positive potential or we called higher potential, then the body is also with the low concentration of electron. Now body A has high concentration of electron and body B has
लो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, द कन्वीनियंस ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ फ्लो इज हाई टू लो. तो इलेक्ट्रॉन इज फ्रॉम द बॉडी ए टू बी, फ्लो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम ए टू बी, वाइल हायर पोटेंशियल टू लोअर पोटेंशियल, विच मीन्स करंट कैन फ्लो फ्रॉम द बॉडी बी टू बॉडी ए. दैट इज करंट इज फ्लो फ्रॉम हायर पोटेंशियल बॉडी बी टू लोअर पोटेंशियल बॉडी ए. सो द मोमेंट ऑफ करंट इज ऑलवेज फ्रॉम द पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ अ बॉडी टू ऑफ अ सोर्स बॉडी टू द लोअर पोटेंशियल. कॉपी स्टूडेंट दिस ऑल. Write a note student, this moment of current is till the body have the difference between the potential. If they get the potential same as body A and B, so there is no flow of current takes or electron takes from any of the other. Now we write some definition or definition of electric potential and potential difference. Let me rub it. First we take definition of electric potential. Suppose a charge is a unit charge is kept at infinity and it is carrying to point A. Therefore, this charge is carrying from infinity to point A. Therefore, we define electric potential. Electric potential at a point, we call it is A. Electric potential at a point is defined as the amount of work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to that point. It is denoted by capital V and mathematically expressed as electric potential is equal to work done upon charge. That is, V is equal to W upon Q. Its unit is volt. Volt is the name of scientist, so it is written as capital V. Or unit of work is joule and unit of charge is coulomb. Therefore, the unit of electric potential is also joule per coulomb. Now we take the definition of potential difference. Okay, student. Potential difference. We have a unit positive charge at point B which is carried to point A. Therefore, the potential is defined between two points. So, potential difference between two points is defined as the amount of work done in bringing a unit positive charge between two points. It is denoted by capital V or PD. Therefore, potential difference is given by work done from B to A. Because you write the definition of this, so we use work done from B to A, carrying to B to A. Okay? Therefore, potential difference of AB, A to B, is given by amount of work done from B to A upon Q. Its unit is also volt or this. Copy this. In the next lecture, we write the definition of 1 volt and then we go for the Ohm's law or the concept of resistance. Okay, student, thank you.